Welcome back, everyone, to another Dicon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today we're going to be reacting to Mountain, Mississippi Queen. Now, unfortunately, the circumstances as to what brought this song to my attention is that a member of the band just passed away. So before we begin, I would like to pay tribute to Leslie West, who was a guitarist who belted out Mississippi Queen, who passed away at the age of 75, all right? Thank you to the people who brought this to my attention. A few different people brought it up. So let me just read what Rolling Stone wrote about him, because I don't think I've ever heard anything by a Mountain before. So Leslie West, the towering guitarist who created the hard rock milestone Mississippi Queen with his band Mountain, died Wednesday morning. His brother confirmed the musician's death to Rolling Stone. He was 75 years old. The cause of death was cardiac arrest. So, released in 1970 on Mountain's debut album, Climbing, Mississippi Queen was 2.5 minutes of boisterous bliss built around West's burly yowl and guitar blasts and drummer Quirky Lang's completely unironic cowbell. Okay. So, I'm very excited to check this song out. Thank you to the people who brought this to my attention. May Leslie rest in peace. Thank you all for joining me. As we've done a couple of times on the channel before, let's appreciate the art that these artists created, you know? They left a legacy behind. Let's begin on Mountains. So, here we go. This song is called Mississippi Queen. It's relatively short, 2 minutes 30 seconds long. I've got the lyrics pulled up in the separate tab. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Just turn it up all the way, you know what? Time I pause it, bring it back. All right, the lyrics are relatively straightforward. I love that guitar so much. It's awesome. And the cowbell, I think hearing that instrument will forever just make me think of the Saturday Night Live skit for Don't Fear the Reaper. But nevertheless, I love it. Such a driving force. The guitar is awesome. Like, the tone of the guitar and the distortion, love it. I love his voice as well. Yeah, let's keep going. above the aggression when he says, "I beg your pardon. Boy, I beg your pardon. I was getting mine." All right. I was going to leave a comment, but the comments are turned off, so okay. Yeah, link to the original video will be down below in the description. Go listen to some mountain. All right, so that was awesome, first of all. I love it. Like I said, the guitar tone is awesome. Sounds very... I don't know what a good word for it is. I really liked it. So he says, "Mississippi Queen, if you know what I mean," right? So Mississippi Queen is the name of a riverboat. It's actually a number of different ones, but presumably the songwriters were thinking of a specific one when they cobbled together two different songs to produce this hit. The best known riverboat of this name was named after the song, not vice versa. Built in 1976, the Mississippi Queen was the largest riverboat in history at the time. It was intended by the America Riverboat Company to embody the dying tradition and style of riverboats of the previous 150 years. That's interesting. Because when I'm hearing all that, I was thinking it's about a girl, you know? Mississippi Queen, she taught me everything. Way down in Vicksburg. Vicksburg is a town in Warren County, Mississippi. The town is right next to the Mississippi River. Again, I'm reading the comments or the annotations that these people leave next to the songs to try and help people understand it better, which makes it a popular rest spot for steamboats, such as the Mississippi Queen boat the song is named after. Okay, so this is an ethnicity in the Louisiana area that originated in Canada in the late 17th and early 18th centuries. Okay. All right. So she was a dancer. She moved better on wine. Makes it sound like she's... Oh, okay. This riverboat goes up and down the river. She loves a challenge and a tussle. Slow and steady looks faster going the hard way. Okay. Interesting. So when I was listening to the song, I was not thinking of a boat. But thinking of it in that, with that mindset does add a whole nother dynamic to the song, which is very interesting. I like that. "This lady asked me if I would be her man. You know, I told her I do what I can to keep her looking pretty by her dresses that shine. While the rest of them dudes were making their friends, boy, I beg your pardon, I was losing mine." And a repeat of the chorus. "While the rest of them dudes were getting their kicks, boy, I beg your pardon, I was getting mine. Oh, Mississippi Queen." Let's see if there's any song facts on Mississippi Queen. Lyrics meaning, I guess. Let's see if song facts has put together anything. Yes, they have. Alrighty then. Thank you for joining me, by the way. It's charted number 21 in the U.S. Mountains guitarist Leslie West explained how Mississippi Queen came together. "When Corky, the drummer, brought me the idea, it was a one-chord dance song. We got real high, took out a napkin, I came up with the main riff and the chords, then we fit the words over the sound. I was madly in love with the band, I believe, and I decided to put a Cripple Creek feel behind it. Later on, I told Levin Helm that I felt bad about ripping him off, but he said he didn't hear any similarity between the two songs, and that we didn't owe them any money." Oh, okay. Interesting. I've never heard that song. I think I've only listened to one song by the band. Yeah, this is kind of what... Oh, okay. So there's two different... Okay. The song, according to Song Facts, is about a seductive woman who teaches the singer a thing or two about the ways of love. Yeah, so it's like everything I know... Or she taught me a thing or two. Where did it? Let me find it. She taught me everything I know, you know? With the success of the song Proud Mary a year earlier, it almost sounds like this could be another song about a riverboat. In 1976, the Mississippi Queen riverboat was put into service by the Delta Queen Company, taking its last cruise in 2008. This is one of the most famous cowbell songs of all time. But the band didn't envision the instrument in the song. In a SongFacts interview with Leslie West, he explained the cowbell in the beginning was just there because Felix wanted Corky to count the song off. So he used the cowbell to count it off. It wasn't put there on purpose. And it became a quintessential cowbell song. Mississippi is a special place for Leslie West, not only because of this song, but it's where he had part of his leg amputated. Wow. When I play Mississippi Queen now, I think about Jesus Christ. Of all the places to lose my leg, it was Mississippi. It was used in a bunch of different movies and games and TV shows. In a commercial. And it got a music video, it says, in 2020. Oh, wow. Probably should have used that. I don't know where I could find it, though. All right, I'm going to subscribe to their channel. You guys should do the same. Again, link in the description. And, yeah, thank you very much for joining me. Hey, Leslie West, rest in peace. That song was freaking awesome. Kick butt, you know? Yeah. So thank you guys very much for, you know, leading me to this and letting me know what happened. And I will see you guys soon. Deathstroke 9 out. Thank you for joining me. Hope you have a great day.